Well, hidey ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Guitto / Joyo pedalboard that we assembled in the last episode, and then ultimately that we're going to be giving away. It's back there on the desk, and we'll be looking at the individual pedals today, and then doing a demo of the pedals and showing you kind of what they can do. And I got a special guest to play guitar on that too. And we'll get some input from him as far as what he thinks of the pedals. And without any further ado, let's just do some of the housework regarding giveaways. Saw the last video, I also put up a link to a video about avoiding scammers, and I'll put that up here again. Just so you know, there are people out there who are nefarious. There are people who will try to take advantage of you. The only way you can win this is go to the link that is given and just follow the instructions. The only way you will get contacted is through that. So you won't see anything in the comments saying, oh, you're one of the finalists, or no. It's not the way it works. Don't respond to anybody unless it's coming directly from me. And you'll know that because, well, you'll know. So anyway, let's just get to it and take a look at the pedals and what they do. Alrighty, folks, so here are three pedals. So we got the California Sound, the Extreme Metal, and the High Gain Distortion. Now, for those of you who didn't watch last week's episode, I would suggest, highly suggest, you go back and look at that so you kind of get an idea of what we're doing here. But the basic idea is to set up this pedal board to be basically like a small gig rig. So basically, you don't need to bring an amp. This is your amp. So the California Sound is your amp. I did an episode on the American Sound, which is kind of like a Fender Deluxe kind of pedal. And this is supposed to be, the California Sound is supposed to be a Mesa Boogie kind of tone. And then of course, these are just your normal, well, not normal, but these are your distortion pedals. High gain distortion, which the way I kind of think of it, is a tube screamer on steroids. And then extreme metal is exactly what it says it is. So we'll be checking all of these out individually. So let's do that. So here is the California pedal. So what I'm using here is a PRS SE Standard 24. We'll go over what each dial does. Some of them are pretty self-explanatory, but this is kind of the setup we used when Erick was doing his tracks. So, but let's check it out. We'll turn it on. So as you can hear, it's very meaty, and it definitely has a little bit of a Mesa-esque kind of tone to it. Now, you can get a clean tone out of it. You just kind of turn the drive down and you can get more of a clean tone, but that's not what we're going after, because the idea behind this is that we wanted this to be kind of, you're in a rock band, you're in a metal band or whatever, and you got a small gig and you want to use this. You basically don't want to lug your amp around to play, you know, a small gig or something. So this is something you could use. Okay, EQ is very self-explanatory. So it is very usable in its entire range. It's not like you have to turn it halfway to get some sort of difference. So level is exactly what it sounds like. It's just the level that's coming out of the output. So that's just to get your basic gain structure. Drive is exactly what you expect it to be. But voice, and just like on the American sound pedal, this is the wonder knob. So this is where you can really dial in a very specific tone. And it's kind of hard to describe what it does. So I'm just going to kind of play, just kind of strum a chord and turn the knob so you can hear it. But that is essentially the California sound. Very versatile. These pedals, the California sound, they also have one that's like an AC tone, that's like an AC30, an Oxford, which is like an orange. So there's a bunch of different flavors of this out there. I would tell every single guitarist, find which one works best for you and just go buy one. They're like $40. And you just put this in your gig bag and you just leave it there. It can run off a battery. So you don't even need to have electricity. But you put this in your gig bag, and if something were to happen, your amp goes down, something strange happens where you can't use your amp, bam, there's your solution. Find something that dials in, that dial it in the way you want it, and then just leave it there, put it in your gig bag, plop a battery in it, and bam. If you have an emergency need for it on a gig, you got it. It's $40. And it's like the best $40 insurance policy you'll ever buy. Plus, for certain situations, like I said, small gigs, recording, things like that. Man, these things are something else. They really are. For what you could buy, and don't get me wrong, I'm not saying like the Strymon isn't amazing. It's amazing. Universal Audio puts one out. That's phenomenal. But they're like $400. And you could buy literally every single one of these for less money than just buying one of those. So it's a pretty amazing value for money, for sure. All right, let's move on to the extreme metal. So here's our basic sound we were getting with the California. All right, so now let's go ahead and turn on the extreme metal. So yeah, it's crunchy. Now this also has a boost feature. And you can hear it really dials. It's not necessarily a boost of volume, although it does have some influence on the gain. What it is more is it's almost like a parametric sweep, so you can boost certain, so like if you're doing a lead or something and you want to boost up like the high mids or something like that, that's what you can do. And again, EQ is pretty self-explanatory, high, mid, low, and the same sort of thing. Level is, well, just as you would expect it to be, it's the output of the pedal itself. Drive is exactly what you would think it is. So yeah, it does. Let's go back to just the with it off so you can hear the difference. So yeah, it's the, well, what's the word I'm looking for? Oh, it's extreme, but it's really cool. It's a very cool pedal. Now let's take a look at the high gain distortion. Alrighty, so now the high gain distortion. Again, this is just our basic sound using the California sound pedal. And now the high gain distortion. So as you can hear, for me, it's a lot like a, kind of like a tube screamer, but with more gain, a more gainy version of a tube screamer. And you can hear it as soon as you turn it on. It's got some noise. But again, put a noise gate in front of that, you won't even hear it. So that's the high gain distortion. I mean, all three are very useful pedals. All three are very, very versatile. And that California sound pedal, man, that whole series of pedals, I'm unbelievably impressed with. So now let's take a look at the demo, because that's where we're going to get into some fun. All right, Erick, what do you think of the Joyo pedals here? You use the extreme one and the California sound primarily. What'd you think?
Man, kind of blown me away. Even just sitting here tweaking around with the sounds, like there's a lot of variables that you can put into these pedals. Get just about any sound. I mean, the California we kind of talked about off camera being the kind of Mesa-y sound, and I mean it has that. It definitely has that. The extreme, I mean, it does the thing, you know. If you're looking for an extreme like metal sounding pedal, that it does the thing.
Does it?
Does it really well.
The thing that has impressed me with both of them, and actually just doing with the high gain distortion and even the American sound in the last video I did, the thing that gets me about it is how usable the sweep is on all of the knobs. It's not like you go, you know, halfway up before you start hearing a difference. It is absolutely, now it may not be a sound that you like for that particular moment, but it's making a difference. The sweep is completely usable from one end to the other on every single control.
It is. And something that I noticed too is, like, compared to other pedals that I've tried that are kind of in the similar, you know, preampy world, I find it hard to find a usable tone. Like, you kind of have to sit at that 12 o'clock position for it to be usable. This, I mean, you can, if you really want a super extreme scooped mid sound, you can get that. If you want a more mid heavy, it doesn't get really, like, honky. You know, it's still a very usable.
Yeah, I noticed that too when you were setting it up. I mean, you really cranked the mid way beyond anything, but I know what you were doing. You were just, like, looking, seeing, but at no time did it become harsh.
Yeah.
It's just like, yeah, wow, that's super midi, but completely, like, not, like, ear splitting. Yeah. So it was neat. Thanks. Good work.
Thank you.
All right. All right. That's going to wrap up our look at the Guitto pedalboard and the Joyo pedals. First, I'd like to thank Erick Goin for coming out and playing the lead guitar track. Did an excellent job. Check out all of his social info in the description below. And like to give a big thanks to the folks at Joyo for sending this stuff out. A, for us to check out and see what it's like, but also to be able to give it away to you guys. So that's all that's left. We just got to give it away to somebody. So go ahead and check out the information in the description below. Follow the instructions. And when we draw a winner, you will be notified by email. And that's it. Questions, comments, concerns,
cries of outrage.
Hit me up in comments below. We'll catch you guys later. Good luck on winning this. You're going to like it.